the principles of respect for people, justice, and beneficence give us the pillars of our research practices. We started with such a strong ethical foundation as our guide for research. And yet,
Indian tribe wins fight to limit research of its DNA. Texas sued over sale of baby blood samples.
I don't have a problem with the testing, but I wish they'd asked us first. I feel like my trust has been taken.
Those pillars are becoming eroded. What new ethical dilemmas do we face? Where did we go wrong? And how can we find our way from here? The main way we used to protect people who donated specimens or health information was to remove their names and other identifying information. We thought this might protect their privacy. What our industry did not anticipate was that it might not demonstrate adequate respect. Respect shown by letting people make their own choices, letting people be aware of the different ways their blood or data is used in research.
Using samples that are de-identified allows you to do more easily, allows you to do things and avert the risks of identifiability, et cetera, to some extent. On the other hand, I think we're entering a phase where it's kind of a problem because people have an expectation, a desire to get something back from the research that's not just an aggregate result, not just a headline in the news. They'd like to be able to access the realizing that the monies are being spent to generate this information and that there's potential for that information to be of benefit to them directly.
There are also reasons you would like to keep folks identifiable. To be able to answer more research questions, you need to be able to follow changes in folks' health over time. If you want to share research results, you need to know who and where the participants are. The other problem with identifiability, in addition to the risk of exposure, is it can mean a lot more paperwork. Paperwork for the researcher as well as the patient. How could we simplify this process? We urgently need to think through our system of oversight, as well as our system of consent and review. Consider new methods of showing respect for people and giving them a meaningful choice, at the very least, making them feel engaged in the process.
If you have to give your tissue as part of the surgical consent process, and there's no other hospital in the city that can do that procedure, how's that consent? That feels to me more like coercion. And it's not that I wouldn't want to give it, it's that I'd want to be asked.
Many institutions are making innovative changes, being bold, and to really work for meaningful change. Working together, communicating, creating a repository of ideas. We can restore the foundation of our pillars of research ethics.
You really are going to depend upon these people in a tangible way over time. And I think the time part is becoming even more and more critical.
Please engage and help us with your ideas.